Hello friends, I'm Urvashi, an educator on Unacademy. You can follow me on Unacademy Learning app where you can find many other courses as well. In this lesson, I'm going to explain VSP, that is Vestigial Sideband Modulation Technique. You can rate, review and recommend this lesson among your friends and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, Unacademy Engineering Students. So, let's start with the lesson. Have a good day. Welcome to the course Communication System. In our previous lecture, we have discussed about single sideband suppressed carrier, that is SSBSC. But in SSBSC, it was not possible to transmit the video signal and it is limited to the voice signal transmission. It can't transmit video and audio signals. So for the video and audio signal transmission, we have a new modulation technique known as the Vestigial Sideband Modulation. Why in the SSBSC we were unable to transmit the video? Because in that it is not possible to have the ideal bandpass filter. So here in this VSP technique we are not using that bandpass filter and we are using some other filter. So let's start this technique, vestigial sideband modulation. We know it is used for the modulation and it is used for video transmission. Video's transmission signal has a bandwidth of 4.5 MHz and for AM or DSPSC bandwidth is 2 Omega, that is 2 into 4.5, that is 9 MHz. And TV signal contain both video as well as audio signal. So I'm approximating it to 10 MHz. And coaxial cable has a channel bandwidth of 600 MHz. So the number of channels that can be multiplexed is the 60. How we will get this 60? It is by dividing this channel bandwidth with this of TV signal bandwidth. That is 600 divided by 10, that is 60 TV channels can be multiplexed. And for SSP, required bandwidth is omega, that is 4.5 MHz. So number of TV channels that can be multiplexed is the 120 TV channels. But it is not possible to transmit the video signal through SSP, so we can't use this. And we have to use the next modulation technique, that is the VSP modulation technique, which have a bandwidth similar to that of the SSP modulation technique. But it can comfortably transmit the video signal. How to generate this VSP signal? It can be generated through the DSP. Like in the SSBSC, we have generated through DSBSC, that is first we have generated the DSBSC signal and then using the bandpass filter we have generated the SSBSC signal. Only the difference here is that we are using the vestigial filter in place of the bandpass filter. Vestigial filter. This filter is also known as the sideband shaping filter. Let us consider a massive signal MT whose spectrum is this MF. And we know our DSP signal has a spectrum of this shape in which no carrier is present and both the upper sideband and the lower sideband are present. Let us consider a filter. This blue line shows the filter, that is the bandpass filter. But here we are using the vestigial filter which have a property that some part of the signal outside is also passed and this line cuts this axis and this axis in mid, so this area and this area should be equal. That time the filter will be the vestigial filter and we will multiply this signal with this vestigial filter, then we get this VSP signal. In this VSP signal we are skipping some portion of this upper sideband and using some portion of the lower sideband, but it do not cause any problem and we can recover the massive signal easily from this. Now let us see how to recover the massive signal, that is the VSP demodulation. For the VSP demodulation also we use a synchronous detector, that is we have used this synchronous detector for the AM, DSP, then SSBSC and now also for the VSB. This is the block diagram of this demodulator in which a multiplier and low pass filter is present.
At the multiplier input, we have this VSB signal and the local oscillator, that is the carrier signal. When these two signals get multiplied by this signal and then pass through the low pass filter, we will get our original message signal back. This is the spectrum of the USB signal. We can see that here this area and this area are equal. That is, we are passing some portion of the lower sideband and neglecting some portion of the upper sideband. And these two portions should be of equal area. And at the multiplier output, when this signal gets multiplied by the carrier, it gets shifted by the frequency FC. So on shifting this with FC and minus FC, we will get this signal at the output of the multiplier. That is, this when gets shifted by the FC, we will get this, and when this gets shifted, we will get this signal. So this portion we are getting twice, and hence at the output of the low pass filter, we are getting the original message signal, as this portion covers this part. So we are getting the message signal back from this. And here is a condition to recover this message signal. What is that condition? Condition is that HF minus FC plus HF plus FC should be constant. That is, what is HF? HF is the transfer function of this filter, that is the vestigial filter. This is our vestigial filter. When this HF gets shifted by minus FC, that is get delayed, that time this is the spectrum, and when then HF is shifted by plus FC, that is the advancing, we will get this signal. And when these two get added, that time the function is this. So this function follows the transfer function of the system, which completely passes this message signal, and we can recover the message signal in the output. So this is the demodulation of the VSB signal. Now let us compare our modulation techniques on the basis of the bandwidth and the power. For the bandwidth basis, AM and DSP have the same bandwidth, that is the bandwidth twice of the bandwidth of the message signal. And this bandwidth is greater than that of the VSB. That is, VSB have a bandwidth requirement less than that of AM and DSP. But bandwidth requirement for VSB is still greater than that of the SSB. So this is the order for the bandwidth. A question can be asked from this in the ES examination, or it can be in any PSU exam. Next is the power. Power of the AM is greater, that is, in the AM the carrier is not suppressed, that is, carrier is present, due to which a large amount of power is wasted in the form of the carrier. So in the AM, power requirement is higher. Then in the DSP, this carrier gets suppressed, so the power requirement is reduced, but it is greater than that of VSB. And VSB and SSB have same power requirement, in that this one signal, that is the one sideband, also gets suppressed along with the carrier, so power requirement further get decreased. So that's all about the VSP. So we have covered all the demodulation technique related to the AM, that is the amplitude modulation, in which we have completed AM, DSP, SSB, SC and the VSP. And this VSP is used for the transmission of the video signal. So in our next lecture, we will discuss angle modulation. Thank you.